For anyone who's new to Docker, I just wanted to bring to your attention the Docker extension for Visual Studio Code. This can be a really handy extension for those who want to interact with containers and for those like me who forget commands very quickly. So if you head over to the extensions and type in Docker, no doubt that will appear. There we go. So go ahead and install that. And once you've done that, on the left-hand side, you can see we have now have the Docker icon. So if you haven't already installed Docker, then you will find at the bottom of this set of menus, there is an option to install Docker. So go ahead and install Docker. That should install the Docker desktop for your OS. Now, I'm assuming that you already know what a container is, and maybe you know how to create a container. But from here, you can see this drop-down list. The first option is containers, and that gives us a nice set of tools to help us start to work with containers. Now, you can see that I've already got some containers running, and if I right-click, it then gives me a few options to help me interact with that container. So if you are developing inside containers, maybe you want to access the files, and this gives us a nice little drop-down here tool that allows us to kind of drop into our folder structure. And then if we want to, we can open up files directly here. So this is a file actually inside of this container, which we're opening in Visual Studio Code. So in addition to that, we also have a few options. If you right click on the container, we can view the logs. So if you're running a server inside of your container, you can go ahead and access that through the logs, for example. Or we can attach a shell. So sometimes you want to run commands inside of that container. So again, these are just commands we can just type into our terminal to access our container, but this just makes it nice and handy if, like I said, like me, you forget all the different commands. So that gives us access to the container or the command line in the container. So you can see there are other options here, drop down, so we can access the images. There's not much we can do there, in all honesty, but if we want some more information about registries, networks, volumes, and then finally, there's an option here for context, then that's all readily available here on the menu. So that's all kind of the visual elements of this extension, but there are lots of other tools that this is providing us. So again, if you start to forget some of the commands, then by all means open up the command palette, either utilizing the shortcut or going to the menu view. And here we can type in Docker, and there's predefined commands that we can access, either working with containers or maybe images. So it's just a case of selecting one of these commands, and that will then help us out, remind us of the commands that we need to run. And then potentially, for example, if you're working with containers and you want to stop, for example, we can then choose which container we want to stop. Here's a drop-down list. There's only one container, part 7, that's the name of the container. So I could go ahead and just stop all my containers. And you can see it's going ahead and doing that. So this extension will help us develop our Docker file and Docker Compose file. There is Intellisense built into this. So if we do make a mistake, for example, like that, you can see it's not indented correctly. It is going to start to give us some information about where errors are in our code. In addition to that, we've got things like code snippets. So if we are building our Docker Compose file, for example, want to add some ports, you can see we've got some code snippets and IntelliSense all kind of built in here. So that just can speed up the development process. All in all, it's worth having a look and utilizing it if you are using Docker and Visual Studio Code. Some useful features there to kind of streamline, support the process of using, managing Docker.